Okay, so students, I'm back with your next topic, and your next topic is story sums. So what are story sums? Story sums are type of questions that will have story, and you will have to solve it. You will have to find out the answer, whether it is addition or whether it is a subtraction. So addition story sums we all have done. Now we will move to the subtraction story sum. Same thing is there. There will be a story and you will have to find out the difference. Trust me, it will be easy. So let's begin your class. Story sums. A balloon seller had 125 balloons. He sold 99 balloons by the end of the day. How many balloons are left with him? In these types of question arises when you have been asked to tell how many balloons are left. You see the word left. These type of words, when comes in a story type of sums, we need to do subtraction. So here, there was a balloon seller and he had 125 balloons with him. And after a few hours, 99 balloons were sold. How many balloons are left? What we're going to do? We're going to write 125 minus 99. Now what happens? When we subtract 9 minus 5, this is the problem of borrowing. Question of borrowing. We cannot subtract 9 from 5, so we will carry 1. We will carry 1 from the tens place. So 2 becomes 1 when carried, and 5 becomes 15. Now we can easily subtract 9 from 15. Now when we subtract 15 minus 9, we get 6. Okay? Then we move to the tens place. 1 minus 9 is equal to 1 minus 9. Can you say 9 can be subtracted from 1? We cannot subtract 9 from 1. So we will take 1 from the 100 place. So 1 becomes 11. Now we can easily subtract 11 minus 9. This is equal to 2. And this becomes 0. So 0, copy it down. So when 125 minus 99, when we subtract this, we get 26 as the difference of these numbers. So total number of balloons left with the balloon seller is 26. 26 balloons are left with him. Clear? We have to do subtraction. We have studied subtraction of 3-digit numbers with borrowing. This is the subtraction of 3-digit numbers with borrowing. If you haven't watched the video of subtraction with borrowing of 3-digit numbers, first go and watch that. Then you will understand the how I have done subtraction over here. Let us move to your next question. These type of story sums will make you solve your questions easily. Now the question says, Avni has 87 pencils. There is a girl whose name is Avni. She has 87 pencils. She gave 29 pencils to his sister. Avni has 29 pencils. She gave 29 pencils to his sisters. How many pencils are left with him? Again, the word here comes left. When this left comes, what we have to do? We have to do subtraction. So we have to do subtraction. We will write 87 minus 29. And in the above, we will write tens and ones. Now we have to do subtraction. First, we will do subtraction of ones. We cannot subtract 9 from 7 because 9 is bigger than 7. So we will borrow 1 tens from 8 tens. When we will borrow 1 tens from 8 tens, 8 becomes 7. And when we have borrowed one-tenths, that is one-tenth we have borrowed and we already have 7 ones. So 1/10 is 10 and 7 ones is 7. This becomes 17. So when we have borrowed 1/10, 7 becomes 17. Now we can easily subtract 17 minus 9. Now tell me, students, what is the answer of 17 minus 9? So the answer is 8. Okay, 17 minus 9 is equal to 8. Now when we have borrowed 1/10, 8 becomes 7. So 7 minus 2 is equal to 5. Now how many pencils are left with Avni? 58 pencils are left with Avni. Clear everyone? Let us solve one more example. On a rainy day, 103 children did not come to school. So there often occurs that when there is rainy season, students don't come to school. So suppose that there was a rainy day and 103 children did not come to school. And if there are 200 children in the school, how many children came to school? So suppose in your class 3, there are 200 students in your class and 103 students did not come to school due to rain. So how many students came to school? Or how many students are present? So how we will do this? Total number of students in the school is 200. And how many students did not come to school? 103. We have to do subtraction. 0 minus 3. Can we subtract 3 from 0? No. We cannot subtract 3 from 0. We will have to borrow 1/10 from the tens column. But what we see here is also 0. So we will have to borrow 100 from the 100 column. So when we borrow 100 from the 100 column to the tens place, 2 becomes 1. 0 becomes 10. And now we can easily borrow 1/10 from 10 ones. So when we have borrowed 1/10 from 10 ones, 0 becomes 1/10 we have borrowed and we already have 0 ones. 1/10 is 10 plus 0 is equal to 10. So in the ones place, it becomes 10. Now when we have borrowed 1/10, 10 becomes 9. Okay, so 10 minus 3 is equal to 7. 9 minus 0 is equal to 9. And 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. So how many students came to school? 97 students came to school. Did you understand how we did subtraction of 103 from 200? You can easily see, students, here it is 0 and here it is 3. We cannot subtract 3 from 0. We need to borrow 1/10 from the tens column. How we will borrow? Here is also 0. So we will have to borrow 100 from the 100 column. So when we will borrow, 2 becomes 1. Now when we have borrowed here, 0 becomes 10. We have borrowed 100. So here becomes 10 ones. 10 ones is equal to 100. Clear? Now 10 ones, from the 10 ones, we can easily take 1/10. When we will take 1/10 from 10 tens, it will become 9 tens. Now when we have taken 1/10, 1/10 we have taken and 0 ones we have added. So 10 plus 0 becomes 10. So here becomes 10. Now we can easily subtract 3 from 10. 10 minus 3 is equal to 7. Now when we have borrowed 1/10, 10 becomes 9. 9 minus 0 is equal to 9. and 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. Clear, students? If you haven't watched subtraction of 3-digit numbers with borrowing, first go and watch it. How many times you want to watch it, go and watch till it becomes clear to you. And then you come to this topic, story sums, so that it becomes easy for you to solve these type of questions. Now we have solved 3 questions. There are many more questions in your book. I would like you to solve the other questions also. Practice this question 2 to 3 times in your rough copy, as well as write the notes in your maths classwork copy also. Till then, if you have any problems, do watch the video again and again. You will clearly understand. I have made you understand in a very simple manner. So practice more and more. Till then, I'll meet you in your next class. Bye bye. Take care.